Tabitha, I love your work. Anyway, with the weather, it's going to be a little cold tonight with local frost and a minimum of 5 degrees. But don't worry, the sun will shine tomorrow. Tomorrow, tomorrow, there... Yeah, you're right, I should probably get up singing and just get on with the weather. Okay. Yes, the sun is going to shine tomorrow and we'll have a minimum of 23 degrees with local northeasterly winds. With Wednesday, we can expect rain developing, gusty winds and 21 degrees. Thursday, rain easing to showers, little windy and 19 degrees. With Friday, rain easing to a shower and two clearing and 19 degrees. Now let's go to this fabulous Squeal episode.
The moment I wake up, before I put on my makeup, I say a little prayer for you. Walk home in my hair now, and wondering what dress to wear.
Good evening. And welcome back to Ben TV. My name's Vivian St. James and I'm just filling in for Tabitha of Turlington as she prepares to pay homage to one of Melbourne's great performers, Miss Kylie Minogue. Right back there, Tabitha.
Oh, you know, I'm limbering up, I'm just doing a bit of floor exercise, I'm stretching, doing all that. Hammies are in great condition and my breasts are looking amazing.
Fantastic. So let's go right over to the centre stage and check out Tabitha.
Thank you.
that was the fantastic Miss Tabitha Turlington and her rendition of that classic drag hit. And now over to the news desk.
Thank you so much, Vivian. Just quickly, we've got to say happy birthday, of course, to the Laird Hotel. It's 20th birthday. So they've certainly been around for a while, longer than the Pier, a lot longer than a lot of venues, probably around the time of Mandate, if anyone ever remembers that anymore. If you feel like you're in a prison, remember Mandate? I do. Amnesty International, Australia's annual Candle Day, is their major fundraiser, and it's coming up soon. So if you'd like to help, call Amnesty International on 1800 808 157 or make a donation before Friday the 20th of October. That'd be really appreciated. The Ultimate Ball 2000 is on at Paran Town Hall on Saturday the 28th of October. It's a fundraiser for the Metropolitan Community Church, and you can contact them on 9 879 1704. That's 9 879 1704. And don't forget, a big date coming up, and you should all start getting ready for it. It's Pride March 2001. Some would say the new millennium, some would not. Sunday the 21st of January 2001. If you haven't got a group to march with, come up, march with us, because we'll be there too. Bent TV, don't forget, Sunday 21st of January 2001. And finally, older gays and lesbians, we want to hear from you. The Also Foundation is conducting a needs assessment of gays and lesbians over the age of 50, and they urgently need people to complete a survey. If you'd like to share your experiences and talk about your current and future needs, if you're over 50 and live in Victoria, then contact the Older Persons Survey Project at the Also Foundation on 9510-5569. That's 9510-5569. And Tabitha, all sweaty as she is back at her desk and waiting for you.
Oh, thank you for that, Michael. That was great. And yes, and I am limbered, loose and rumble. Well, not loose, but ready to go.
Yeah, right.
Now, Monique, you've got a news item for me, sweetheart.
I do. Can we get a picture of this at all? Maybe. Over there.
Yeah.
Over here. Saki, missing Saki. I miss Saki too. I love Saki. But this poor tiger.
She was great.
Lukewarm, tepid. This tiger had its mate stolen, and it was taken to bits for those aphrodisiac sort of bits, and now it's refusing to eat, which is really sad. But
what
a gorgeous little thing. Well, let me just
read.
What
kind is it?
I just looked at the picture.
San Diego Zoo, Melbourne Zoo. India.
Over a bad zoo. Southern India.
Oh, that's disgusting, isn't it?
They probably cut off his bits for, you know, like...
To go with
tiger balls, aphrodisiac tablets and all that stuff.
Or maybe, like, for Indian love eggs, maybe they might use the testicles for that.
They probably do.
Them and buzz them over. That's shocking. Vivian, you had a news item about a G-string or something, sweetheart?
No, I had a news item about ice replacing heroin, the new drug on the streets, apparently. It's
called white ice.
Yes, and apparently it says here... It's used by young women to lose weight, and we're distributing it throughout Commercial Road, and hopefully some of us...
Okay, now we can't be promoting drug taking on this show. We can have white ice cream, but not white ice.
Well, if you take Globe to the nth degree, there's probably a few pharmacists down at Fruits and Suits.
Pharmacists, doctors, scientists... All sorts of interesting people.
Do you have any prescriptions in their pocket?
Yeah, pads.
Do you have bodgy doctors? No, because it's really hard to find a really good bodgy doctor, because sometimes you want things, and you know your doctor would go, oh, I'm sorry, I'm not giving you that, but I want that. This is the only way I can lose weight is
Duramax.
Exactly. Well, I actually go to a surgeon and they say, oh, no, I wouldn't take that much out. I'm going to take it all out plus a little bit more.
Have you ever found a bodgy doctor, Monique?
I do. I had a great one when I was at uni, and I'd walk in and he goes, right, how many days do you want?
Actually, speaking of which, I've got a mate who, you know, when you just don't feel like going to work, was only this week, by the way, he works for Grand Casino. Anyway... Went to the doctors, just waiting for that usual, I got pissed last night, I need a sick day off type thing. Bloke said to him, where do you work? Crank Casino. Oh, you're seriously depressed. 2 weeks.
Oh, that's sensational. That is great. We'll come back to that after what we're going to now is another segment of footage, of course, behind the scenes at Joy Melbourne 90.7 on your FM dial with our roving reporter, Steve Anderssen, and John Jennings. Take it away, John and Steve.
Here we are at Joy Melbourne Radio 90.7.
RMIT-FM on your dial here in Melbourne. Gay, lesbian, transgender, bisexual, and all those other little bits and pieces in between.
And the first in Australia. Got to get that point across.
And one that we're particularly proud of because we really like this station. And I just noticed someone sitting here busily at a desk. Excuse me, miss, are you a lesbian, miss?
Oh, my girlfriend says I am.
Well, then she must be right. Mark Gardner, how are you?
I'm well, Steve, and yourself?
I'm pretty groovy. You've been on Squeal before.
I have. I've been squealed, and it was so much fun.
So what are you doing here at this desk here?
Well, I'm actually preparing our application for a full-time community broadcasting licence. As you know, we temporarily broadcast when the ABA lets us on air with a licence, and we hope that by next year we'll be on air full-time.
And what is required for you to actually achieve that goal?
We have to prove that we serve a particular community, in our case obviously the GLBT, GFPL,
OXYZ
community, and that the community wants us and needs us, and that we serve the community's needs in a way that no other media organisation does, and we certainly believe we do that.
Well, I think we can all safely say that you do that, but the matter is to prove it.
We do need to prove it. We're currently going through statistical evidence such as the VGLRL's Enough is Enough survey, and also seeking support from other gay and lesbian organisations.
So what can those people out there in Bent Television land do to help Joy Melbourne here in Joy Melbourne land?
The easiest thing you can do is become a member of Joy Melbourne, 969 00907, if you want to join, or you can become a volunteer. Write us a love letter and a letter of support, but the easiest way is probably that phone number again. I reckon you could say it, Steve.
969 00907. Ah, I got it.
Thanks a lot.
No worries. Thank you. Keep working there. You've got a lot of work to do, girl.
Okay.
I'm Steve Anderssen, reporting to you live from Joy Melbourne, here in the heart of Melbourne.
Oh, and now we're back, of course, in the squealing things. And thanks for that, Lois. That was sensational. And John, taking us, of course, behind the backing rooms and so, whatnot and stuff, and everything's exciting at 90.7, Joy Melbourne, on your FM dial.
It's a lot like Club 80, isn't it?
Well, I think it's actually that is what it is when it's not Joy Melbourne.
Oh, really?
I think it's a sex room, yes. I think there's heavier that going. Well, I think that's how some of them have kept their jobs. I'm not sure. I don't know, but, I mean, that's what I've got to do.
That's what I heard.
Oh, but I won't do that at the hotel I work at night time, because you just wouldn't do that. Yeah. Now, of course, something very fresh to me. We're going to come back with it after the break, and, of course, that is whatever. Who cares? Bye!